Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we are going to study about the UMTS standardization and releases. Various versions or the releases of the UMTS were done, and every version had an enhancement from its previous version. Let us see what were those enhancements. The first release, that was a UMTS 99 or the R99, was used for the addition of a network which is called as the UTRAN, which stands for UMTS Radio Access Network. This network was basically added on to the circuit switch network and the GPRS architecture for enhanced data rates. The additional elements that were being added for the UTRAN were called as the RNC, which is the radio network controller, and the node B. Remember, we have seen the structures in the architecture of the UMTS. So this overlay was done to increase the data rates as well as to increase the core bandwidth of the network. Remember, UMTS uses WCDMA as the air interface, in which the bandwidth of the channel is widely been increased. Let us now see the other releases. So the next release, that is the UMTS 2000 or the R00, was done to support the edge as well as the GPRS. Mainly they provided aspects such as radio aspects, that is they enhanced the radio features. They also provided end-to-end quality of service messaging. They also provided various codecs, that is coders as well as decoders. And finally, they provided several data compression mechanisms. There were basically two releases of this standard, which is called as Release 4 and Release 5. So the Release 4 basically separates the transport and the control in the IP domain. The Release 5 basically specified the IP core networks for all the multimedia services. The next is the UMTS Release 6. This UMTS Release 6 specified the HSUPA, which stands for High Speed Uplink Packet Access. This is basically a 3G mobile protocol which gives a very high uplink packet data rates in the range of 5.76 Mbps. The technical purpose of the enhanced uplink was to improve the capacity as well as to improve the throughput and to reduce the delays. So the next releases of the UMTS were Release 7 and Release 8. What they basically did was, they reduced the latency, they used in emergency call handling, enhanced data rates, IP-based multimedia services, increased throughput, increased data rates up to 100 Mbps in the downlink and in 50 Mbps in the uplink direction. Now we move on to the Release 9. The Release 9 specifies the OFDM packet access. This is basically the 4G technology that has been used. This 4G technology is based on the OFDM radio interface. This allows the data throughput of 100 Mbps in the downlink direction and 50 Mbps in the uplink direction. The basic idea of the multi-carrier is to improve the spectrum efficiency and better utilization of the resources. Remember, we know that OFDM is nothing but orthogonal frequency division multiple access, in which multiple carriers are used to transmit the information. And because we are using multiple carriers, more amount of information is getting transmitted, and all the carriers need to be orthogonal to each other. And hence, in this case, we are having better spectrum efficiency because of the orthogonality. So this were about the releases and the standards of the UMTS. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.